Hello everyone, and welcome. Today it's time for another edition of Fire Emblem Heroes Sleeper Skills, the series where we take a look at skills that can be hard to find a home for. Today we're talking about one of the most unique abilities in the entire game, Shield Pulse. Shield Pulse is a B skill, with an equip cost of 240 skill points. It can be inherited onto melee infantry and melee armor. It's also very rare. Shield Pulse can only be found on two units, Saber and Fjorm. Shield Pulse combines two effects. First, it grants a one-time pre-charge bonus to defensive specials on turn 1, so skills like Ice Mirror or Miracle can receive the bonus, but skills like Bonfire or Aether can't. Second, when a defensive special triggers, Shield Pulse reduces the damage you take by 5 on top of other damage mitigation. That may not sound like much, but 5 damage reduction can go a long way. Shield Pulse, for all of its text, isn't really complicated. It lets you use defensive specials more often and makes them better when you do. So how can we utilize this? Well, let's run through a few options. First, we have Guaranteed Miracle. For anyone who may be new, Miracle is a defensive special that activates when a unit receives lethal damage. Instead of dying, Miracle leaves them at 1 HP. By combining Shield Pulse and Special Accelerators, a player can guarantee that Miracle will activate within one round of combat, or even pre-charge it completely. In other words, your unit will almost always survive the first round. This combination was showcased in-game via the Developer Challenge map series, but that was months and months ago. Miracle builds have major weaknesses. First, if you don't have a healer, it leaves you at 1 HP. You survive, but your combat options are limited. Second, Miracle only works on one hit, not one round. If your opponent activates Miracle on the first hit, a follow-up or brave attack can still kill you. The second way to use Shield Pulse is probably the intended use case, building ultra-tanky units. Someone like Brave Ike can become nearly indestructible when equipped with Shield Pulse. They can maintain a 100% uptime on Aegis or Sacred Cowl, and reduce a ton of incoming range damage. These builds are very durable, but without a special, it's hard to one-round KO, and your opponent will have plenty of opportunities to dance, Wings of Mercy, or otherwise ruin your day. The third way is by far my favorite, building all-in player phase attackers. This strategy relies on the way that defensive specials scale. To see what I mean, let's consider an example. In combat, if you take 20 damage, Pavis can reduce that to 10. In this instance, Pavis saved you 10 HP. However, if you take 50 damage, Pavis reduces that to 25, saving 25 HP instead. The percentage is the same, but the effect is larger. The value of defensive specials increases with the damage you take, or more accurately, it is inversely related to your defense and res. Low defense and res makes defensive specials, and by extension Shield Pulse, stronger in absolute terms. This enables otherwise squishy melee units to tank obscene amounts of damage, even when using life and death. Units like Carla, Raven, or Soleil can dump their defensive stats and build around Shield Pulse to survive. Other strong contenders are units with excessive hit points, like Carol, Bartra, or once again, Carla. These units survive their first combat on raw HP most of the time, so they don't really need defense and res. Okay, let's take a look at a few builds. As always, these aren't the only ways to use Shield Pulse, there are just a few that I like. First, we have Shield Pulse Female Corrin. This build was featured in one of Seer Cull's highlight videos linked in the description below. The idea is that we use Sacred Cowl to offset Corrin's low res, while her speed and defense keep her safe in melee. This set is really hard to kill in a single round. As a bonus, with the power of Dark Breath, Corrin can wreak havoc on the enemy team with debuffs. While old, this build still works. Between Cowl, Shield Pulse, and debuffs, Female Corrin can become a potent bruiser. She's harder to deal with than her appearance might let on. Next up is a Shield Pulse Raven build using doubled up life and death. Although this set is weaker than a Gale Force build, it's a unique option that Raven can use if you want something different and fun. The combo of Pavis, Shield Pulse, and then Heavy or Flashing Blade enables 100% uptime on the defensive special, and makes Raven almost impossible to kill in a single round of melee. As a bonus, the near-guaranteed survival ensures that Raven can be danced off of Wings of Mercy, or be used for other nasty tricks. The only reason this works is the sheer power of Raven's offense. With defense scaling being what it is, Player phase shield pulse builds need absurdly high damage output or effective damage to excel. Raven fits the bill thanks to his personal axe with built-in life and death. The rest of this build kind of makes itself. Three spots are taken by the combo, the special, the seal, and the bee. The last set I want to share with you today is one of my new favorites, Sorcery Blade Saber. For what it's worth, this build is not set in stone. Saber's stats, weapons, and skill options give you a lot of viable Sorcery Blade configurations. Saber is also, well, very expensive. Anyway, the key here is the A skill. Saber is one of the best natural users of Sorcery Blade. The adaptive damage helps overcome Saber's lack of a damaging special. It all works together and is much stronger than the sum of its parts. Golden Dagger provides DC, Sorcery Blade provides damage, and Shield Pulse keeps you alive. What more can you really ask for? The C and Seal are both flexible. Now, there is a cost here. Sorcery Blade is reliant on its condition, so you can only use this Saber variant in certain team setups. Overall, Shield Pulse is one of the most unique skills in Fire Emblem Heroes. It has a very high opportunity cost, taking up both your special and B skill, but the payoff can be worth it. In terms of magnitude, Shield Pulse is exceedingly powerful, granting both precharge and consistent damage reduction. It's a skill that rewards you for thinking outside the box. It's best for players who realize that offensive specials aren't the be-all end-all of Heroes combat. Going forward, I hope that IS takes the time to print new defensive special choices. The category could be so much more than it is, and with a handful of additions, Shield Pulse could truly come into its own. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like or subscribing. You can find me on Twitter, at DireThunderYT, so feel free to send me cool stuff or just drop by to say hello. As always, I hope to see you next time. Take care.